Good afternoon. Earlier today, the jury in the criminal case of Officer William Porter ended its deliberations without being able to reach a unanimous verdict. All of us, if we believe in justice, must have respect for the outcome of the judicial process. This is our American system of justice. 12 Baltimore City residents answered the solemn call to serve. They listened to the evidence presented, and they rendered a decision. If some choose to protest, they must peacefully demonstrate. That is their right. But I also want to be very, very clear about any potential disturbances in our city. We are prepared to respond. We will protect our residents. We will protect our neighborhoods, our businesses, and we will protect the safety of our first responders. I urge everyone to remember that collectively our reaction needs to be one of respect for our neighborhoods and for the residents and the businesses of our city and for those who have answered the call to serve and protect. We will not and cannot be defined by the unrest of last spring. As a city, as a community, we are stronger and we are united to be better than what some displayed to the world in the spring. For the past 8 months, we have worked relentlessly to unite Baltimore with a resolve to have peace in our streets. We have a chance to show the country how to be heard peacefully, respectfully, and effectively. I know that as a community, we are up to the task. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. For the protesters, and there are certainly protesters out on our streets right now, and there will be in the days to come, we respect the right of Americans to protest. Protesters who are lawfully assembled have a friend in the Baltimore Police Department. We are here to serve as peacekeepers, quite frankly. So we respect the right to protest. We respect protesters and what they have meant for so many years in this great country of ours. And those protesters who are lawfully assembled, again, will find that our police department respects them and will do everything we can to afford them the ability to protest in this city. Folks who choose to commit crimes and hurt people and break things and harm people are no longer protesters. You lose your ability to call yourself a protester when you choose to harm people and destroy property. So I think that's something we've spoken about for a few months now. I believe the vast majority of folks, quite frankly, understand that very, very well. We, too, respect the criminal justice process in this country, and we exist to protect it. And we pledge to this city, both our police department and our fire department. We have Fire Chief Niles Ford here with us today. Our pledge to the folks in Baltimore is one of public safety. We're here to protect, we're here to serve, and we take that responsibility very, very seriously. Thank you.
Did anyone have any brief questions?
Commissioner Davis, you had said that you were monitoring social media on April 27th. Is there any signs similar to disturbance that you had seen that you're monitoring on social media now?
We continue to monitor social media. We have a pretty robust system in place to make sure that we have every capacity available to identify things that we should know about. And right now, there's nothing that concerns us, nothing that has been brought to our attention at this moment that doesn't give us the impression of any type of wrongdoing whatsoever.
Commissioner, I know your comments may be brief in what you can say or limited in what you can say, but one of your officers in his trial, now his trial declared a mistrial. What's your reaction to that?
Well, my reaction is it's part of this process and in this great American criminal justice process. And you know, many Americans think that it's imperfect, our criminal justice process, and maybe it is imperfect, but it sure beats what comes in second. So I think we all have to respect the process. The process is ongoing. It's not the last time we'll talk about it, and I think we just have to be consistent, measured, and thoughtful as we go forward, because Baltimoreans need to know that their police department, of all groups of people, have to respect the criminal justice process, and we do.
Commissioner, Officer Porter's status remains the same at this point as it was this morning?
Right. He remains suspended without pay.
Any other questions?
Can anyone touch on the arrest that was made outside of the courthouse?
I guess briefly, we have many, many partners here. And I'll say one thing about Maryland law enforcement. There's no other place in the country, and I'm biased, that does this thing better than Maryland public safety. We really have come together as a team to ensure that this great city is protected. I do know that the Sheriff's Department has made a couple of arrests. I'm not sure the exact nature of those arrests, and I'm sure that's something that they'll be addressing as the night moves on. Well, we have many strategies in place in West Baltimore, East Baltimore, South Baltimore, North Baltimore, throughout this city to ensure that the peace is kept. I intend to visit West Baltimore later tonight. As you probably know, there's been groups of faith-based folks who have spent the last couple nights in West Baltimore, in North and Penn, holding hands, speaking with one another, saying prayers for this great city, and I intend to join them later tonight as a show of unity and a show of peace.
Good,
Dakari.
What role can you say that the war room is playing in this, and have you requested any additional help from federal authorities tonight?
Well, we have an incident command structure. We have the Office of Emergency Management plays a vital role. So, again, Maryland law enforcement has come together in a very unique way. You know, we're not a big state, but we're big in terms of our fraternalism with one another, and everyone across this state, every jurisdiction, every county across this state, has really stepped up and has pledged to protect this great city that really defines Maryland in so many special ways. So it's a great partnership.
Barry Sims.
Mayor, what do you say to the protesters and others who feel that this is just another sign of things that have happened in the past, that there is no justice, and they feel discouraged by what's happened today? What do you say to them?
I would say that we have to respect the process. When we ask, let me start by saying this. The protesters were very clear that they supported this trial being held in Baltimore City. That means that they put the case in the hands of Baltimore City residents. 12 Baltimore City residents answered that very solemn call to serve, to hear this case, and to make a decision. They did that. And we have to respect that if we think that the process will be able to continue in Baltimore City. We have to respect the process. Justice is not a verdict. Justice is a process that we have to protect.
Madam Mayor, in terms of what we've seen on social media, what we're seeing on social media at this hour, people are tweeting and so forth about Baltimore City being on edge. What you have seen today, how would you characterize Baltimore City in terms of its response?
I would say that Baltimore City is prepared. I think in efforts for some of your peers to have something to say about what's going on in Baltimore, they have characterized us as on edge. I've been very clear that we're prepared for whatever happens. And I think that what you're seeing today bears that out.
How many police officers are in Baltimore City today from various agencies?
We're not going to get into the exact numbers because that's part of our strategy, but there are enough people here, law enforcement, public safety, to serve as peacekeepers to protect this great city.
And do you have federal officers as well as state officers?
The federal law enforcement agencies play a role. Obviously, their roles are different, and our partnerships with them continue. But this is a local law enforcement public safety effort, and so as we serve as peacekeepers, we're doing it not only with our partners throughout the state of Maryland, we're doing it with our community. So you've seen them out at North and Penn the last couple nights. You'll see them out there again tonight, I'm sure. But the community is our biggest partner as we move forward in the days ahead.
All right. Thank you guys very much. If we have the need to hold any additional press conferences, we'll announce those via Twitter for our people who have come in town. For our local media, they'll get their normal emails that we get, but for people out from outside of town, it'll be announced on our Baltimore Police Twitter handle. Thank you guys very much. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
All right.